Esther who needs a home for the future? Or is it time to downsize and move to another home that's actually more suitable for your glorious retirement years? In today's Home Selling Tips video, I'm here to talk to you about common mistakes that empty nesters make. Stay tuned to the end of this video for a free, exclusive report that will definitely help you in avoiding some of these common downsizing and starting over mistakes that empty nesters often make. Like thousands of residents here in the Greenwood area, you may be discovering that after years of nonstop child traffic in and out of your doors, toys on the floor, music floating throughout, and suddenly you could hear a pin drop over the quiet hum of the refrigerator. Your rooms are filled with pictures and memories of this wonderful time in your life, but there are many empty rooms gathering dust right now that your children have moved on. The freer years ahead are the exciting ones to look forward to, and it's time for you to move on as well. If you find yourself in this situation, you're in vast and good company, and what that means is that there are many wonderful opportunities for you to create in this new chapter of your life. If you know what it takes to get the most out of the equity that you've built up in your current home, here's some important things to keep in mind when moving on from the family home. Some empty nesters base their decision on where to move for their next home base and how close they might want to be to other family members, including their children. Now, this one can be risky sometimes because so many young adults in the family have not completely settled down as far as their careers are or where they've decided to raise their families. It's only logical to wait for everything to be in order for them before making any big decision about where you're going to live next. You also need to think about getting in touch with downsizing. Many empty nesters waste valuable money holding on to many things that they do not need, or even worse yet, pay for exorbitant storage fees for things that they're never going to use again. They might also depend too much on the benefits of the sale of their existing home. Selling a home doesn't always turn out to net as much as they might have expected, and that can leave the senior or empty nester underfunded as far as moving to their next future home. Also, you want to think about interest rates and property taxes because those could be potential problems. You may have gotten your current home at a really great rate today. Your current rate might be much higher than what you currently have. There's a lot more to learn in preparing for this new chapter in your life. To help you understand more on the issues involved with making such a move and how to avoid 9 common and costly mistakes most empty nesters make, grab a copy of this free report by visiting www.gwdemptynesters.com or give me a call at 864-766-SOLD. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and don't forget to click the bell icons to get updates on my new videos. Also, please like my Facebook page, Instagram, and Twitter at Kellar Lawrence Real Estate for the latest news and updates. If you got any questions, leave a comment in the section below and I'll answer them as soon as I can. And thank you so much for watching today. See you next time.